In this video, we will learn how to simulate and compare the filter performance of these capacitor layouts. Let's simply start with the simulation process. First, download the KiCad layouts from the link in the description and open the first layout with KiCad. Now open FreeCAD, create a new project, run the FreeCAD to openEMS macro. If you are new to this channel, in the video description there is a link to a tutorial video on how to install openEMS on Windows. Import the KiCad layout. The import progress will be shown in the report view. And once finished, an all done message will appear. Close the macro window. I defined a copper thickness of 0.2 mm. I did this to reduce simulation times. Of course, you can change the copper and PCB thickness. You can do this in the KiCad layer stack menu. Change to the part workbench. We will now create the input port. Do this by creating a box, then resize it. And move it into position. Rename it to port in. Create a copy of it. Call the copy port out. And move it to the output position. Now create another cube and call it air. Resize and place it so that it covers the PCB in all directions. Just keep a few millimeters distance from the top side of the PCB. To see what's going on inside the air box, we can make it transparent. Now create one more cube and call it C1. This will be our first capacitor. We will draw a simple 0.4 or 2 capacitor. Move it into position. Copy it, call the new object C2 and move it into place. I kept some distance between the capacitors and the traces. This is because you must connect only the very ends of the capacitors. To make the capacitors more realistic, we will add a Z-Rense resistance to them. I will do this by splitting up the capacitors into two parts and defining one half as the capacitance and one half as resistance. We will now create four pads to connect the capacitors to the copper. For this, just follow my steps. We now basically have all the parts that we need and could already start with the simulation setup. But to reduce simulation time, I will change to full copper vias. This is because the plating of vias is typically very thin and this would lead to long simulation times. For this specific video, the exact via impedance is not too critical, so I can afford to lose some precision to speed up the simulation. To create full copper vias, first expand this object and fuse these two objects. To remove the resulting extensions, create a new box and make it cover them. Now first click on the fuse object and then on the box and click on cut. We now end up with fully copper filled vias. Now mark the copper structure and the four pads. and create the union of them. Let's now clean up our object tree to make it easier to select the correct objects later. Mark the board and the copper object and create a simple copy of them. Now delete all the non-simple objects. Before we proceed, let's save the FreeCAD project. Rerun the FreeCAD to openEMS macro and let's work through the tabs. Skip the object assignment tab for now. Set up the grid in the grids tab. In the materials tab, add air and FR4. In the excitation tab, create the sine wave excitation of 100 MHz. Now define the ports in the port settings tab. In the lumped parts tab, define two capacitors and two series resistances. In the simulation params tab, set the number of time steps to 1. Now go back to the object assignment tab and assign the components. Save the settings file. Generate the openEMS files. Change to the Processings tab and generate the S21 code. Now go to the Simulation Output folder and open the MATLAB script with Octave. Run the main code and confirm the prompt with yes. Close the 3D preview window. After a few seconds, the command window will tell you how many time steps the excitation takes. Copy the value and change the number of time steps in the code to the same value. Rerun the main code. Once done, open the S21 code. Set this value to 1. This will create the file with the simulation results. Now run the code. Open the generated CSV file. This here is the S21 value for 100 MHz. I will create a second spreadsheet and note this value down. After repeating the same simulation for different frequencies, you get this response. Let's create the XY graph from it. Here is the result for the butterfly configuration, but it looks almost identical to the parallel layout. This is because the trace of the butterfly layout is quite long. But even with this long trace, the butterfly configuration performs as good as the parallel layout. This should give us hope that we can improve on that. This now is the result after moving the capacitors a bit closer together. Now we can definitely see an improvement. The anti-parallel configuration gives us an additional performance boost. And rotating the anti-parallel configuration seems even better. So it probably is true that the anti-parallel configuration in some way improves the filtering effect. But I'm not completely convinced yet, and we will have to double check this on real PCBs. This leads us to the sponsor of this video, the software tool HQDFM from NextPCB. HQDFM checks your Gerber and PCBA files based on the manufacturer's design rules. If you want to order fully assembled boards, you can use the PCBA check to make sure your board is ready for production. For example, my KiCad design rules didn't catch that fiducials are missing. HQDFM is completely free and there are many video tutorials available on how to use it. If you want to check it out, a link to it is in the description. When looking at the screenshot from the last video, the free terminal capacitor promises an improvement of more than 20 decibels, but we only have reached 5 decibels so far. So here would be the simulated result with a free terminal capacitor. And here is the result after placing it closer to the noise source. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.